Okay, Positive TV gets lots of electric vehicles today. I've started off on a scooter, this is completely electric, and I'm hoping obviously to build myself up to a BMW, Toyota Prius, something like that, and maybe, you never know, they might give me one. Watch with me.
I'm Stephen Glazer, and I'm the founder and director of the Revolve Eco Rally. I was involved in promoting a certain technology, something called fuel cells, which were invented in Britain 150 years ago. People say nothing good is new, it's true. I was promoting that technology in vehicles and in other applications, and I thought the best way to do that is to do it in vehicles, because, you know, there are fuel cell boilers, there are fuel cell power supplies, there's all kinds of things, but no one would follow a Brighton to London boiler rally, would they? So you do things with cars. Cars are sexy. People like cars. They can relate to it. Cars are much more than from A to B. We can pull people into that event doing it like that. The basic formula is that we get all the best cars together, try and convince the OEMs to play with us, and we've got just about every OEM, apart from one, I think, involved this year. And get celebrities and other dignitaries, well-known faces, to drive them, and, you know, the press will come and we'll make a big bang. So we don't want to have any accidents, but we do want to make a big bang.
Hi, my name's Danny Tendler, and I'm from eCity Wheels, and these are our bikes, the electrocycles.
And this is the electric motor, which is embedded into the tire, which is connected to a controller, hooked up to the batteries, and adjusted by a throttle, and that's all that there is to it. This is basically about it.
It's just got a kettle lead on it and a wall plug.
It's as if you were plugging in your laptop or a mobile phone.
It takes about 5 to 8 hours for a full charge, so it can be done overnight. And it'll take between 1 and 2 kilowatt hours to fully charge the batteries.
Okay, I suppose.
Which works out to about 5 to 15p.
Yeah, good afternoon. I'm John Kingston. I look after government affairs and environment for Honda in the UK. And this is the Honda Insight. It's our latest generation petrol electric hybrid vehicle. Effectively, you've got a standard petrol engine in the car.
Okay.
And bolted onto it is an electric motor.
Right.
And the two power the vehicle together. So the electric motor is assisting or helping out the petrol engine.
Right.
So as a result of that assistance by the electric motor, petrol engine's working less hard,
right,
using less fuel,
right,
and there's less emissions. So you've got a cleaner package.
Okay, so this is where we refuel with hydrogen. And that's a standard hydrogen refueling nozzle.
So the green light goes on that says ready.
Yeah, when that stops flashing, saying it's ready.
Okay, so what? Now this
we're ready to go.
How did it feel to drive?
I've never driven anything like it. I mean, I'm not as much of a sports car driver, but this thing, it's completely silent, no pollution at all, and for people who like sports cars, no compromise. It's an incredible car. It's 100 times more impressive than I'd even imagined. It's extraordinary.
0-60 in 3.9 seconds, and it'll do that on about 4 pounds of electricity, and it has a range of about 200 miles on that charge. So it's a very environmental way to drive, but also a very economical way to drive.
I've seen the difference here is if you go across there and you chat to the scooter guy, he'll tell you it's 4p a day.
Yeah.
And yours is like £4 a day. So this is the luxury.
Right, if you drive 200 miles, right. This is a car. And cars have, more space and slightly more luxurious inside.
Indeed.
Which is good.
And you look a lot better.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I'm not sure. Scooters are kind of cool. But yeah, it's real. I mean, the most important about this car is it's real. We deliver them to customers. Customers drive them. We've delivered 500 cars to customers now. So, it's a real vehicle.
And of course, the luxury item, it does cost a luxury price tag, doesn't
it? Yeah, well, you have to start somewhere. And in the history of all new technology, it generally starts off fairly expensive. So yes, this is an expensive product. And it sells to people that want that sort of price range vehicle.
My question is, what's the problem here today? What are we trying to address?
We're trying to address about three huge problems. One is climate change, the other is air quality, and the third is weaning us off the dependence on hydrocarbons and oil from potentially unstable countries. And it was a dwindling resource anyway. So there's a fantastic opportunity to solve those problems with wonderful new technology of the kind we've got here.
And what have you found that's really inspired you?
A huge number of things, all of which are producing a great deal of food for thought. They're all being fed into my biomethane catalytic cracker. And we're gonna work out how. I think there's some fantastic things here that we need to promote.
I'm Quentin Wilson, and I've been doing this thing for the last 3 years. We began in 07, and people looked at us as complete cranks, weirdos with a lot of funny cars that didn't make any noise or any smoke. And here we are, strangely, in the month that General Motors has filed for Chapter 11, because they made pickup trucks and SUVs that did 8 miles to the gallon, and they just completely misinterpreted the market. And it's a fantastic feeling to be here, to know that this technology is here and now, and the speed of change is ferocious, absolutely ferocious. And what is so good is the consumer now really does want to drive cars like these, and they want better air quality, and they want energy security and low CO2. And the excitement of driving, as I have today, a Tesla Roadster, which is purely electric and does 60 in 3.9 breathless seconds. So it's not dull, it's not worthy, it's not, you know, unexciting, quite the opposite. This is the most exciting time for the motor industry since the Model T.
Had a stunning day at City Hall. All these fantastic vehicles of all different types and varieties. So all that we have to do now is to choose which one I want to take home with me, because apparently I get to take one. And so I'm thinking about the Tesla, obviously, because that's very expensive. But on the other hand, I do fancy a new scooter as well. And so should I go for hydrogen? Should I go for electric? Maybe I should go for a car that's powered by banana skins. Whatever it may be. Anyway, you enjoy yourselves, and I'm just going to go and choose myself a slick new car. See you then.